Hello students, in today's video we will be revising the chapter reproduction. Okay, so we will do a rapid revision of this chapter. So what is reproduction? Reproduction is when an organism gives rise to another organisms of its own kind. The reproduction can be of two types, either asexual or sexual. Okay, asexual means there will be a single parent that is giving rise to the offsprings. Okay, but in sexual reproduction there will be the two parents. Okay, and they will produce the gametes. Okay, they will produce the gametes. These gametes or sex cells will fuse among themselves. Okay, they will cross in order to produce the offsprings. Okay, so what is the major difference in asexual reproduction? Whatever character of the parent is there, the same character will be there in the offsprings also. Okay, but in the case of the sexual reproduction, the character of the offsprings, okay, character of the offsprings will be a combination, okay, or you can say recombination of the parents. Okay, whatever characters are there in the parents. So let us look at some of the asexual reproduction in plants. In plants also there are both asexual and sexual reproduction. So first we will look at some means of asexual reproduction in plants. One of them is sporulation, yeah, spore formation. So certain special structures called sporangium, what they will do, they will produce the spores. Okay, so these are enclosed structures, okay, inside which there will be lot of spores are being produced, which when get matured, this sporangium will get dispersed. It will get disrupted and it will disperse the spores. Okay, each individual spore is capable of forming into the new plant. Okay, then we look at the next type of asexual reproduction, that is a vegetative propagation. What is vegetative propagation? That means some vegetative structure like stem, root, leaf, okay, some of these structure is used for propagating a new plant. So for example, if roots are involved in the vegetative reproduction, in the case of sweet potato, dahlia, okay, guava, mint. Sweet potato and dahlia produce the tuberous roots. Okay, tuberous, that means they appear like tubers, just like sweet potato, just similar to potato, it is a tuberous. In dahlia also it is the same. Okay, but in the case of guava and mint, it is adventitious root. Okay, so the roots will be in this way. Okay, and all of these can be propagated by taking cuttings of the roots. Okay, sweet potato, dahlia, guava, mint. In addition, carrot, turnip and radish can also be used for the vegetative propagation Here what is happening, the difference is that in carrot, turnip, radish, it is the taproot system. For example, carrot, it will appear something like this, right? It is bulky above and down, it becomes thin. Okay. And here you have the leaf-like structure, carrot. So, there are some roots are coming out from this, okay, carrot. If you do a cutting at this place, okay, you cut here in this plane. Then there are some buds that are there here in this in the base of the stem. Okay, this is the root, right? This is the root, and at the base of the stem there are some buds. These buds, they can again form the new plant. Okay, and then again fresh carrots and all, radish, turnip, they can be produced. So in this way vegetative propagation can be done. Okay, but in the case of sweet potato, dahlia, guava, mint, what is happening? It is the exactly the root itself that is used. Next, stems can also be used for the vegetative propagation. Two types of stems we will be looking at. One is the underground stem. So you all know that the stem is the aerial part of the plant and the root is the underground part of the plant. So when we are saying the underground stem, then how can we tell what is the difference between the root and underground stem? How can you identify? Whenever we are talking about stem, it will have the buds, nodes, internodes, leaves. Okay, these kind of structures will be present on the stem. But in the root, these structures will not be present. Okay. So by this way, you can identify whether that given structure is a stem or a root. Okay. For example, there are the four types of the underground stem. One is the rhizome, tuber, bulb, and corm. Okay, these are the four types of the underground stem. So rhizome, it is very compact, swollen underground stem with a very scaly leaves. Okay, so do you think that roots can have leaves? Roots will not have leaves. So it is a underground, it is a modified stem. So here example is ginger and banana. Here the underground part, that is the rhizome, is horizontal. Okay, it is horizontal and it is having lot of scaly leaves and it is capable of producing the new plant. A tuber, just like in the case of potato, okay, in the case of potato, the tuber is an underground stem. So directly from the underground stem, you will see that multiple potatoes will form. Okay. Form. Bulb. Bulb, it is like a disc-like structure. Okay. And it will have the, like in the case of onion, garlic, lily. What is happening? It will be in this kind of a structure. Okay. So the apical bud is capable of forming a shoot which will have the flower on the top. Okay, and these there are the many scale leaves. This can have lateral buds that can also form the stem. Okay, so that is the case of bulb. In the case of corm, what is happening? Example is Colocasia, okay, and gladiolus. What is happening? It is also like a rhizome, but it is vertical. Okay. It just like, okay. So here the big leaves will be there and all. So underground is here, ginger, it is horizontal. It is growing horizontally, but the corm, it is growing vertically. It is a modified like a rhizome, but vertically arranged, and it is very compact and stumpy. Okay. next. Okay, so what we are seeing here are examples: bulb, comb, tuber, okay, and rhizome. Rhizome is vertically, is horizontally arranged, okay, whereas the comb, you can see it is standing, okay. It, but in the case of bulb, there will be layers, there will be scale leaves, but here it is scaly, okay, and it is comb is also having the scaly leaves like the structure of the rhizome. Tubers, you can see they are originating from the stem only, directly each of one of them can form the, for example in potato. What about the aerial stem? Aerial stem, we saw these are all examples of the underground stem. Aerial stem, the example is runner. Okay, runner. So what happens in a runner? For example, in the case of grass and strawberry, the branches, it will, some branches can start from very low, okay, and they will grow almost horizontal to the ground. They will touch at some places, okay. So wherever they are touching the ground, it can form the again roots, and from here the new plant can start, okay. So these are the runners. Example is strawberry and grass. Next, leaves can also be involved in the vegetative propagation. For example, bryophyllum, okay, and begonia. What is happening? The leaves at the apex, they can have some buds, adventitious buds. These adventitious buds, they can form the new plant. Okay. Next. So we have seen that the root, stem, leaves, these three can be used in the vegetative propagation. Next, these were all under what we say natural vegetative propagation. Now we will look at the artificial vegetative propagation. Okay, artificial, okay, artificial vegetative propagation. So under artificial vegetative propagation, we have the cutting, layering, grafting, and tissue culture. Okay, so cutting, for example, in the case of rose, China rose, okay, what is happening? Sugarcane, raspberry, lemon. What happens is we are cutting the branch. Okay, so you can cut the branch and you can use that cutting for propagation of the new plant. Okay, directly. So you may have seen so many times rose cuttings are used directly for the propagation. China rose or hibiscus can be also very much used. Sugarcane is most preferred method, is take the cutting of the stem and you can put. So only care has to be taken that it should have at least one node. Okay. Next, layering. So layering is similar like what we saw here in the top runners. In the case of runners, so what we will be doing is these, wherever it is touching or it is going horizontal, you can put it down artificially and put some soil on top of it, then it will induce it to form the roots. Okay, so because we are not leaving it like that, we are by ourselves artificially doing it, inducing it to do like that, it is, this process is called layering, and it is done in the case of jasmine, strawberry, raspberry. Okay, these are all examples. Grafting. So grafting most common we see in mango, apple, okay, and also in many citrus plants and pear, okay. In grafting what is happening, there will be the two parts. One part is attached to the soil, the stem, and the other part is without the roots, it is on the top. So the one that is with the root, okay, it is known as the stalk, and the top one is known as the scion. Okay, stalk and scion. So the one with the roots is stalk, one without the roots is scion. So in this way, the root cuttings are joined together and they will fuse and they can form the new plant. This is also an artificial method of the vegetative propagation. Tissue culture generally done in the laboratory, okay. And here what is happening, we are taking some explant, okay. Explant is nothing but a small amount of tissue that is taken from a actively growing part of the plant, okay, and then we are allowing it to grow in an artificial medium in the laboratory. So it will form the callus, okay. What is a callus? Callus is a undifferentiated mass of tissue that is developing from the explant. Okay. Once the callus is formed, then it is allowed to differentiate with the help of hormones. Okay. Then what you will get? You will get the plantlets. Okay. These plantlets, they can be transferred to the nursery or directly into the fields. Okay. So these are the four methods of artificial vegetative propagation. We can see some examples with respect to asexual reproduction in other organisms. Okay. So this include the fragmentation, binary fission, multiple fission, okay, and budding. Fragmentation, best example is Spirogyra. So here what is happening, it is present, it is an algae, it is present this way in the form of filaments. So if it is broken, say in between like this, each of these can form a new algal plant, okay, it can form a fresh algae. So in this way it will form the fragments. Fragments can produce the new organism. Binary fission is seen mainly in the case of bacteria, okay, and in Euglena also. So one organism will give rise to just two offsprings, okay. How? It will just divide in between, okay, it will form two halves. So that is the binary fission in bacteria and Euglena. Multiple fission, so this kind of division will be going on, but it is enclosed inside some kind of a covering, okay. Then what happens, a lot of such cells will come together, then we say it is a multiple fission, it will release at a single time. So in case of Chlorella and Chlamydomonas, this kind of situation can be seen, multiple fission. Budding is seen mostly in the case of yeast. Yeast, you know, is used in the baker's yeast in fermentation, making of bread and so on. So in this way, there are the different methods of the asexual reproduction. Okay, we will revise the rest of the chapter in the next video. Please also study from your textbook and revise, solve the end of chapter questions. Best of luck. Thank you.